Hello. My name is Brent Griffin with the Prairie County Cooperative Extension Service. Today we are in a field east of Des Arc, looking at our soybean crop and evaluating what we have. And one thing I wanted to kind of discuss and touch with today is soil chlorides that are starting to show up in our soybean crop. One of the issues with soil chlorides this year, due to the dry weather, is the wicking up on the beds. And I've got a few plants here that are exhibiting symptoms of soil chlorides. In soybeans, we have two types of plants or traits through the genetics, one being includers, the other being excluders. An includer is a plant that will pull the chloride out of the soil, take it into the roots, translocate it throughout the plant stem and up into the leaves, giving this burning effect. In dealing with soil chlorides, the one cultural way that we can manage this issue in our soybeans is to select a cultivar or variety of soybeans that is an excluder. The excluder soybean plants or varieties actually hold the chlorides that are absorbed through the roots in the roots and will not translocate throughout the plant. We have three principal ways in dealing with our soil chlorides here in the state. One is selecting an excluder variety. The other way is by mechanical ways of deep tillage in the fall or winter to help leach out the chlorides that are in our soil. And then the third way is those fields that have a history of chloride issues in soybeans, and especially those fields that have high needs of commercial fertilizers. Those fields should be fertilized in the fall, worked into the soil. That way, by the time the fertilizer dissolves in the soil, the chlorides will be able to leach out for the upcoming year.
Your Arkansas Soybean Podcast is a production of the University of Arkansas System, Division of Agriculture, and was funded in part by the Arkansas Soybean Promotion Board. For more information on soybean farming in Arkansas, contact your local county extension office.